In this video, you will learn the strategy for the perfect welcome email sequence automation flow, as well as I will show you some great example from other brands how they do it.
I will walk you through each email which you should include, but some of them will not apply to your business. So my recommendation for you to start writing them up and maybe cross them out those which do not apply. So how they obtain? They obtain in a footer, they obtain on a homepage pop-up. And also, let's say if we have some kind of exit intent on different pages, like before they leave a website and they are not part of your database, they will obtain to that form. Okay, so after they obtain, they will start receiving those 8 emails. This is my recommendation. You do not need to do those 8 emails. And after a short explanation, I'll show you example of actual brands, how they do it. So the goal, the main goal of this flow is to nurture, to educate this new subscriber about your brand and about your product. So first email, it's a welcome, just simple welcome. Hey, welcome to my brand. Thank you for joining my list. This is what you should expect. I'll start sending you emails, or we have a daily email or so forth. Then email number 2 is our story. Tell them, like, why did you start this brand? Like, who are you all about? What is your team? And so forth. Then email number 3 is social proof. Why should they care? Maybe you have some kind of testimonials, or maybe you're mentioned in a big publication that you want to show it off, or featured on some YouTube channel or Instagram channel. So put it there to prove that you're a big deal. Number 4, talk about how your product solve their pain point. Or if you don't have that problem solution thing, you can create some kind of product content to talk about your product. Then now email number 5 is a product demo. It's explaining how your product works. Maybe you have an explanation video. Maybe you have a demo video and so forth. Only in email number 6 and 7, we are introducing discounts. Because if they did not purchase up to email 6 and 7, it's a good chance we need to incentivize them somehow. The first 5 emails, we were educating them about the brand. And we do not want to offer them any discount before, because it's like proposing on the first date. If you show the discount in the first email, like, hey, buy from me, they don't know who you are before they want to start spending money with you. So in email number 6, we introducing discount. And in email number 7, it's last chance to have a discount. We always have a 2 emails per discount. In the first email, we introducing discount saying, hey, here's a discount, but it's only available for 24, 48, 72 hours. And then we're following up with those who didn't purchase and say, hey, this discount's about to expire. And email number 8 goes only to those who didn't buy. And the purpose of this is to, listen, I gave you the best offer, but you didn't purchase. Why? And you can ask different questions. Try to be short and maybe just have one open-ended question like, hey, I gave you the best offer I could. Why didn't you buy? And they can give you, when you have it open-ended, they will share a bunch of information, and people love to share, trust me. And that information is priceless, because you can use that information and put it back into your funnel, improve your copy, your design, improve your message, which will click with your future email subscribers. Okay, so the strategy is done. This is another video. You can watch it later. You have access to this Miro board where I talk about email design exploration, or examples where you can check how other companies do it to get inspiration for emails. Okay, so everything that I just discussed in strategy, I have it here email by email, and I will go through each email quickly and tell you why I picked that specific email. So the first 2 emails are welcome and our story. And both of them, I took cachava. It's a powder meals, like they high on protein, low on carbs and so forth. It's very healthy. I use them for like almost 6 months instead of my meals. So they are doing great job. So as you can see, it's a healthy combination of copy, text, as well as images. And they telling you, they welcome you to the tribe. Like, hey, like, there's tribe, you know, there's community. This is why you should care. And this is just like well-designed emails with other links to other pieces of content, as well as welcome message. Here, continuation of the same team, but here they are talking about why they created, and it's a kind of letter from the founder. So the social proof, here's, I forgot the name, it's Andy. Yeah, Andy Swimsuit. We love them. We had them on our podcast. We did interview them. them, they have amazing emails. Even if you mail, I strongly recommend to subscribe for their emails just to check out how they do things. The message is great. Design is great. Like they're creative. So here you can see how they repurpose their community and inserting their how their people use how their customer use their brand. So this is a great way to show social proof. Email number 4 is product content. Here's a great example how Casper did it. So they are not talking about their mattresses, but they are talking about what to do, how to pick mattress, what you should not forget, and so forth. It's very, very soft pitch of their product, but mostly it's value checklist. So here's email number 5 example. It's a product demo, again, from Casper. And you can see they are talking about each type of their mattress they have, and short description and shop. So you can, when you click call to action, you will be redirected to that specific product. Okay, as I said before in strategy, email number 5 is the last email where we nurturing our subscribers. Email number 6, we trying to incentivize them with a discount. And here, Yamsol, one of the brand, introducing friends and family discount. So as you can see, they are providing 30% off, but here's a strategy. I would put it on the top saying, hey, it will expire in 48 hours, but they didn't do it. It's maybe their strategic decision, but basically the code will expire in 3 days. And as you can see, they have some social proof like Jennifer Lopez. And here's last chance to get the discount. As you can see, Born Primitive saying, hey, 48 hours left to use your 20 gift voucher. So it builds urgency and reminding people, hey, don't forget this discount and use it. And it converts like charm. So strongly recommend for any discount you do, always at least do 2 emails. Some people do 3, 4, 5, but minimum 2 emails. Introduction, hey, this is a discount. You have X number of hours to use it. And then, hey, discount about to expire. And this is the last email. It's not much design in this email, but I love how he structured the copy. So basically he's asking, hey, I want to improve my business. So I'm asking you to fill up my survey. And for that, I will give you 20% off. And also he said, even if you're not interested to order, I still would like to get your feedback. So this is very powerful. And I strongly recommend to include in your email marketing strategy. And also I have 2 more videos about explaining welcome emails of other brands. So if you want, you can check them out. So this is a strategy for welcome flow, also known as pre-purchase for e-commerce stores, but you can use the same strategy for any other business.
Thank you for watching this video. In case you have any additional questions, please leave them under this video. Subscribe to this YouTube channel as well as like the video. I'm checking the comments on daily basis and responding probably in the 5 business days or less.